The ending of USA Network's Mr. Robot wasn't overly complicated or confusing, but there are multiple ways to describe what actually happened in the last three episodes and how that changes the entire story, each explanation slightly different from the other. Here's my interpretation of my favorite show, Mr. Robot. So far, we know Elliot is a vigilante hacker with differentiative identity disorder who wants to take out the top 1% of the 1%, especially their leader, White Rose. White Rose is the head of the terrorist hacking organization Dark Army. After her lover's untimely death, she becomes obsessed with building a secret machine located at Washington Township nuclear power plant. She kept her project going even when they found out about a toxic leak. 26 employees, including Elliot's father and Angela's mother, died as a result. Their rivalry became even more personal when she killed Elliot's childhood best friend Angela. And once she moves her project to Congo using Elliot's shipping hack, she'll kill him as well. And so to take revenge and to save himself, Elliot, his another personality Mr. Robot, and his sister Darlene hack White Rose's and all her other rich partners' bank accounts and steal all their money. They leak the history of their corruptions and crimes online, including White Rose's identity. After losing her money, position, and power, she still manages to escape arrest and heads to Washington Township. She forcefully starts her machine, even when she knows it can't run properly here. All on a sudden, Dark Army detects Elliot when he inserts a malware into one of their computers. Elliot is then brought to a room similar to where Angela met White Rose in Season 2. There's a copy of Elliot's father's favorite book on a table. Elliot's pet Quoddy is also there, which means White Rose was already expecting Elliot to come here to make his last move to destroy the machine. Usually, White Rose would manipulate her guest into taking a long psychological test to figure out a way to get into his head and make him believe whatever she wants him to believe. Pretty much what she did to Angela. But now, she doesn't have much time. Police has already arrived at the plant, but the few minutes they have, they engage in one of the best conversations took place in the show, and that's saying a lot. It's a battle of beliefs between a tyrannical dictator who uses the excuse of having love for the people to impose her destructive plan on them, and an actual leader of the people who, despite of wanting nothing to do with them, fights for their free will. Elliot is not a saint either. He too played God without permission, but before coming here, he shedded a lot of it by undoing his hack. Maybe with tricks and lies, the season once Elliot could be brought to White Rose's side, but not the Elliot now sitting in front of her. This conversation reveals pretty much what we needed to know about White Rose's machine. It's been hinted throughout the show, and this time it's finalized that the machine is a gateway to an alternative universe. White Rose believes there's an alternative universe for every single possible scenario that could play out. Among them, there's a perfect universe where White Rose can live as her true self and have a normal relationship with her lover. The machine can transport all of us into that perfect universe in a particular time in the past in exchange of the one we live in. In the new world, if White Rose never loses her lover, she won't need to build any machine. No one would die because of a toxic leak. 71 buildings wouldn't need to be burned down. That's what she promised Angela. All the lives lost here will be restored in that alternative universe. This is not just time travel, but time travel to a different reality. So does the machine work? The Washington Township power plant is not sufficient to run the machine properly. That's why she was trying to move it to Congo. But if it was moved to Congo, would it work then? In real life, a very large hadron collider is a research tool. With everything else much closer to reality, how far advanced can the machine in Mr. Robot world be? To imagine a world where there's a machine that can transform this universe into an alternative one? I'd suspect every other technology in that world be much futuristic. Still, I can't fully deny the possibility because the show doesn't do that either. In the end, it doesn't really matter. The right thing to do here would be to destroy the machine, whether it works or not. The reason for that were also reflected in their conversation. Does a perfect world even exist? As long as humans have free will, they will hurt each other, be unfair to each other, and love each other as well. That so-called perfect world would be no better than the world we have. As long as Elliot has people like Darlene, who loves him unconditionally, the perfect world is not worth sacrificing what he has here. Elliot also wants a better world, but he knows to create a better world he has to improve the people. Let it be one by one. On the other hand, White Rose is so much in love with her perfect version of the world, she didn't attach herself to anyone here after her lover's death. She cares so little about the people here that she didn't hesitate to kill thousands of people to take little steps forward. She knew this project will take all her power, money, and most importantly, time in order for her to succeed, and so she used corruption to gain that crazy money She couldn't wait for the leak to be fixed. She couldn't let Philip Price to hold her project down any longer. And so she burned down 71 buildings to regain her power over Price. This is another reason the machine needs to be destroyed. The person behind the wheel is a psychopath. In the end, when she lost, she decided to take out all her frustration on the society by gambling with their lives. She started the machine and left it on Elliot to figure out a way to avoid a meltdown. One explanation of the scene is that White Rose started the machine because she thought the machine would work. Don't think so. She's well aware of what's going to happen. Her laugh, her calm demeanor, her refusal to admit defeat, or that she could at all be wrong, came from her extreme narcissism. She tells Elliot the plant is losing power and makes sure to let him know this all could have been avoided if Elliot had simply let her move the project to Congo, where the machine could run properly. White Rose then shoots herself in the head in the true Dark Army fashion as she lost the only purpose of her life. But Elliot still has to play the game. Before killing herself, White Rose told Elliot, "I'm going to show you what I showed to Angela." Means that there's something still in this room for Elliot to see. Now this is the gamble. If Elliot tries to save his life and leave, people will die, and Elliot himself might not be able to get away in time. But if Elliot cares about people more than his own life, he would stay in, look around, try to see what White Rose wanted him to see, and what choice can he make to stop the meltdown. In the end, Elliot stayed, and with his wits figured out how to stop the machine, unintentionally saving himself by staying in the shielded room as well. Elliot was rescued almost unharmed, and was admitted to a hospital where he was lying unconscious and dreaming of a utopian world. Unaware that he's dreaming, Elliot thought White Rose's machine actually worked. This is the alternative universe. Everyone here are their perfect selves. The only person doesn't fit here is Elliot. Elliot comes across a happier version of himself, someone he would have been if he had the perfect environment the happier Elliot grew up in. Elliot thought he could just take his place without anyone noticing. Finally, Mr. Robot lets him know what actually going on, lets him know that he's not the real Elliot, he's one of Elliot's personality mastermind. The real Elliot Alderson subconsciously created three personalities, the protector, the persecutor, and the younger self, years ago when he was a child. Each of them appear only to handle specific objectives, with Elliot mostly in control. And then very recently, Elliot created Mastermind. Mastermind is the manifestation of Elliot's rage, the rage that has been building up inside Elliot against society, against the top 1% of the 1% who plays God without permission, against people like Edward and Vera, maybe even against himself for not being able to do anything about them. Now here's what I think happened. The first time Mastermind showed his presence was when Elliot was locked in the server room. It was Mastermind who broke all the servers, which Elliot doesn't remember doing. Not Mr. Robot, Mastermind. In the server room, Elliot didn't need protection. He needed to let out his anger. He then showed up again when Darlene came to visit at Halloween. Elliot switches to Mastermind when he puts on the mask. Mastermind then tells Darlene his plans to take down E-Corp and switches back to Elliot right before taking the mask off. He probably kept appearing and talking to Darlene to build up society. He recruited Trendon and Mobley, but couldn't be there to meet them himself, probably because the real Elliot was in control. But soon Mastermind realized, to execute his plan, he needs to be in control all the time. He needs unadulterated, focused rage, which cannot be interrupted by Elliot's social life. Let it be as little as answering Angela in time and showing up at her birthday party. So he trapped Elliot inside an imaginary utopian world and took over. This was the day when he took down Ron instead of going to Angela's birthday party. This day was regarded as the day Mastermind was born, a month later in a dream during his withdrawals. Mastermind used illusion to remain in control. He made up a narrative for himself that he's the only child and the only personality. We've seen him doing this in season 2. The entire time he was in prison, he talked to us and Krista as if he was in his mother's house. But unlike that one time in prison, he started to believe his own made-up story. He forgot what he needed to forget, whoever he needed to forget, to keep believing the story. Mastermind is aware of his fragile mind. He didn't give us imaginary friends any name to remember we only exist in his mind. He asked us from time to time if what he's seeing is real. Still, he chose to create this illusion, and he would have made up another story if in the end he hadn't given the control back to Elliot, to not feel guilty, to remain focused. On the other hand, the real Elliot was trapped in an illusion created by Mastermind. To make sure he never wakes up, he removed the existence of his sister Darlene from the dream world. Darlene is like Elliot's totem. When he used to have his mental episodes, when they were children, he would hold her hand, and as long as he could feel her hand, he would know everything was real. She is Elliot's strongest connection to reality, which Mastermind can't allow Elliot to have. Though Elliot doesn't, Mastermind does have a totem for this world. Annie's totem is Angela, the only person in the dream who knows Mastermind. She now reminds him who he is and what he was created for, just like she did once before. And now that his job is done, he's supposed to let Elliot be back in the real world. But Mastermind refuses until Darlene tells him how much she misses her brother. But why did he change his mind for Darlene? Because he loves her, yes. But let's go a little deeper than that. The day Mr. Robot was created, Darlene was also in Elliot's room. Mr. Robot didn't appear because Elliot was seeking protection. He was created because Elliot needed to protect Darlene. Elliot's way to protect himself was hiding his father's keys to his bedroom, much more rational than throwing himself out of the window. But that day, to protect Darlene, he needed to become a fighter who's not afraid of anyone or anything. The first person Mastermind talked to was also Darlene. The real Elliot woke up and talked to her about Vera without Mastermind and Mr. Robot even noticing. Darlene is like a key to Elliot's mind, locking him in and out of his cage. Darlene inspired Elliot to become more than what he is. She inspired Mastermind to keep going when he didn't have the strength to. She's the only person left in his life who made this world worth fighting for. And this time he could clearly see he can't be the brother she needs. She still misses Elliot just how Angela missed him. Elliot was Angela's only true friend. Maybe if that friend made her believe he was there for her, Angela wouldn't try to take down E-Corp all by herself. She would choose to stay with her friend instead, and this could be the reality. Mastermind himself feels that he's in someone else's place. I say that based on how he was put to his place in his own dream world. In Season 1, in the dream, Mastermind receives a key, immediately seems to win over everyone around him, including Angela. But Angela returns the key cause it doesn't fit. The key is supposed to be Elliot's bedroom's key that his father had. The real Elliot stole this key to fight back, something Mastermind didn't earn and only had the illusion of, among all the other illusions that kept him in control. This is, to me, is an indication that deep down inside he knows he can't replace the real Elliot. Perhaps there's another reason Mastermind gave up control. If Elliot is only allowed to be the manifestation of his rage, then the only life he has to look forward to is of a rageous leader, with many followers, many worshippers, but no real human connections. A leader who only sees his or her goals, and not who can get hurt in the process. Maybe the reason Mastermind gave up control, cause he didn't want to become anything like White Rose. He didn't want any longer to play God without permission. Agree? Disagree? Have any other explanations? Let me know. Like if you like, share if you like, subscribe if you like.